Very good afternoon, student of class 12. This is the part 2 of theory of production. So, in this theory, we have assumed that in this theory, what we have said, I am teaching you the law of variable proportion. In law of variable proportion, we have assumed that if one factor is fixed and other factor is constant. Okay, now we are assuming that these are the labors employed. It is a fixed factor, or we can say this is our x2 and our x1 is land. So in a plot of land, just a minute, I am again repeating, in a plot of land, if more and more laborers will be employed for the purpose of cultivation, at first the total output will definitely increase because the fixed factor will absorb the variable factor to some extent. But when this absorbability rate of the fixed factor will fall down, then what will happen? The total product will not increase. It will fall down, and after some time, what happens? That its additional variable input cannot be employed. What is the meaning? When I have given the example, when a fixed plot of land, we will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Highest capacity, 10. Now, when you will employ 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, you can employ the variable factor. But what will happen? That there will be no improvement in the total production. Better to say that total production will drop down because that too many laborers are not required. Okay, because when it crosses its optimum, when the fixed factor crosses its optimum absorption power, or the absorptivity rate reaches its maximum point, afterward, if the more and more amount of variable output will be engaged in the production, there will be no improvement in the total production. Instead of increasing, the total product will fall. Look at the what happened. In a fixed plot of land, first one unit of laborers has to be employed, and total production and that labor has produced or cultivated 10 units of the plot of land. When two, then both have covered up the 14th part of the land. Third, both have covered up the 20th part of the land. Okay, or the total output is 20. Now, fourth laborers employed, their total output is, TP is 24. When fifth laborers are employed, change, there is no change in the total output. Okay, suppose when one laborer he has produced, suppose, the 20 kg of paddy. Just say, then second, first and second, 40. Third, 20 kg of paddy. Fourth, 24 kg of paddy. Fifth, if I will give one extra labor also, there will be no change in the total production. Again, after fifth, if six laborer will be employed, then the total product will not increase, it will fall. Now, what is the, then here I have written MP, means marginal product. What is that? Change in total product due to change in input employed. What is our variable input employed? That is X2. Now, 14 minus 10. Why? Because change in total output. What is the change in total output? 14 minus 10. And what is the change in X2? That is 2 minus 1. So 4 by 1, answer is 4. So what is the change in marginal output? 4. Means where in a plot of land, one extra labor has been employed, it helps to increase the helps to increase the total amount of production by 4 units. Okay, where 3 laborers have laborers help to enhance the output by 6 units. Now, when fourth labor has been employed, then it helps to enhance the total product by 4 units. Okay, understood. Now, when fifth laborers are employed, it helps to enhance 0 unit. Means, if there is no change in total production, means it its contribution towards the total production is 0. But beforehand, up to fourth labor, they have contributed. Okay? First labor contributed 10, second labor contributed 4, third labor contributed 6, fourth labor contributed 4 towards the total production, means the amount of paddy is increased. First kg, 10 kg, second kg, 14 kg, third kg, 20 kg, fourth kg, 24 kg, fifth it is 24. Means whether the producer will employ the fourth unit of laborers or fifth units of laborer, the result will be same. Now, after fifth, if the sixth unit of laborer will employ, what is its contribution? Its contribution towards the production will be 22 minus 24 minus 2. Means if this laborer is useless or worthless laborer, because if he will be engaged in the production, he will not contribute anything towards the production. Rather, due to his engagement, the total production falls down. So, after fourth unit, no laborers will be employed. So, fifth and sixth unit of laborers is known as marginal. This question is important for exam. Marginal laborers, because their contribution towards the production process is 0. So, who are the marginal laborers? Marginal laborers are those laborers, if they will be included in the production process, their contribution towards the production process will either be 0 or be negative, means they should not be employed. But as we know, Indian agriculture previously was highly populated, that's why this concept came up. Means there were many marginal farmers. Means if one job can be done by 5 laborers, it found that instead of 5 laborers, double labor have been engaged. So these are the useless laborers. Am I clear to you? So their production and contribution towards the total production is 0, and they are known as marginal laborers. Okay, so this what I have taught is for the law of diminishing return. Yes or no? Because the return is diminishing. Okay, after 4th unit, what is happening? That 0 minus 2, it is diminishing. Here see, after 2 units, when 3 units of labor has been employed, obviously it helps to enhance the production by 6 units. But the thing is this, what is happening? 4 to 6, afterwards see, when the 4th unit of labor has been employed, the additional contribution is 4. Whereas, in case when the third unit of labor has been employed, his contribution was 6. Okay, understood? So, what I have said, that keeping one factor fixed, if more and more variable input will be engaged in a fixed plot of land, or fixed unit of any input, then the total production will at first increase, then it will fall down, it becomes 0 and negative. Okay, understood? Here you keep it in mind, the question can come back. With the help of the technical improvement tool, it can, more amount of land can be cultivated. It is very true. With the help of the technical improvement, the more amount of land can be cultivated. But the thing is this concept is not applicable, because when we will explain the law of variation, the given state of technology. There will be no use of technology. It is an old concept. It doesn't have no such right now theory, but practical application, because right now maximum instead of laborer can be replaced by the improved technology. So whatever may be, but this law of diminishing return is not only applicable in agriculture, it can also be applicable in other fields. So it is a very important theory, and this part will be followed by